What's up, everybody? It's your man Chan here with another riff from the six riffs that changed my life forever. That is the opening riff for the song Hangar 18 by Megadeth off their Dark Side of the Moon, I guess, Rust in Peace, early 90s, with Marty Friedman, Nick Menza, Dave Ellefson, and of course, Dave Mustaine. This riff, I had learned it. It took a while to learn, and that's still like, you know, kind of an odd thing for me to play. But I grew up actually in metal, heavy metal. You hear pop and you hear the things that your family plays, you know, R&B, Magic 108. And then a friend of mine turned me on to what is it called? 103.3 KHTR, where, you know, I heard Wham and Pet Shop Boys and all this other stuff, which opened my brain up to other possibilities. But then my friend Dave Funk, who in riff number 3-1 by Metallica, he gave me that disc, or excuse me, gave me that cassette, turned me on to heavy metal, and heard the melodic side to heavy metal, which I just thought it was whatever. But I learned differently. But comes along, you know, Megadeth comes along, and they have, that's called, I guess, a chromatic cliche, or a cliche line, it's like a chromatic build. With triads, and I was learning, you know, power chords. Riff number 4 was Epic by Faith No More, and I'd learned power chords, and my buddies Mike and Will, and then another guitar player that I knew I was playing drums for, actually, his name was Mark Ellidge. He convinced me that, you know, just playing rhythm guitar, you know, it's like, he said, you should get into, you know, playing lead guitar. And I said, nah, I'm cool with rhythm. You know, I'm not so good at playing lead. You know, he's like, well, you know, now, but in a year, just imagine where you'll be. So that turned me on to actually learning about the diatonic modes and pentatonic positions and using scales and exotic scales and things like that. And he was in the orchestra and I was in band, and we were able to talk music often, him, myself, and Will Jones, who was the other guitar player in the band, and our bass player, he was in the orchestra as well, played cello, I believe, at the time. Now he's a professional double bass player, maybe not double bass, but bass player, Andrew Harmon. Thank you, Andrew. He was in our first band. Anyway, those guys, we talked melody as well. And I'm not forgetting you, Zoe, either. He was our singer, but he was a killer guitar player as well. He was a mix between Chris Cornell, Tony Iommi himself, and Randy Rhoads. You know, that guy could play. So, and we were, you know, it was positive competition. Like, we were pushing each other to be better on guitar. And one day, Will and I decided to learn, you know, some songs together. He would go to his teacher, learn things. You know, his teacher would draw it out on, you know, staff paper or guitar tab paper, or, you know, those kinds of examples, and we would bring it home. He would learn it, and he would pass it off to me, and I would learn it too. Eventually, I started taking lessons of my own from that same teacher, Jim Galbiers. Thank you very much, Jim. Hope you're well. Anyway, but learning that line, that guitar line, whatever it is, wherever it goes. Anyway, just taught me a lot about, you know, how riffs weren't just all power chords. Riffs had function and meaning and melody, and, you know, the theory behind them was useful, and it meant something, and it really changed the way I saw music. I thought it was just chunking, you know, swinging baseball bats and hitting brick walls. But there was really a finesse to what these guys were doing, especially listening to Marty Friedman, which turned me on. You know, his phrasing and the way he learned, he knew how to follow chords in his solos, turned me on to players like Alan Holdsworth, who is my all-time favorite guitar player, who just, you know, plays, beats the life out of chords, you know, by playing inside and outside of the scales, and using the entire fretboard, you know, as a canvas to paint these structures, paint these pictures. I liken myself to if B.B. King had Alan Holdsworth's fretboard knowledge, you know, that's kind of the way I play. Like I'm the movie North Shore, the guy's name is Chandler. He's a soul surfer. So I learned how to, you know, I was all about Pantera and, you know, playing with as much speed as possible and all of this stuff. But I learned how to slow down and actually take melody. Not that Dime didn't. But, you know, take melody and really feel it out, you know, put my heart into it and really express what's going on with me. And you'll notice, you know, the things that I play now are quite melodic, and then, you know, have an element of, you know, soundscapes and swaths of sound. I call what I do audio Basquiat. So anyway, you should see that. That's another story. But so Hangar 18 by Megadeth was one of the first riffs that really kind of showed me that, you know, the theory behind music is actually, you know, utilized in a great way. And it's not always just about chunking out, you know, which is great. You know, James Hetfield, what was it? Fucking phenomenal riff, but that one didn't do me as much as... So on and so forth. But anyway, that's riff number 5 today. Thank you so much for watching. Please be sure to like, give this bad boy a thumbs up. Share these videos to friends, you know, that you think that are, you know, that are looking to make changes in their musical palette, you know, make to broaden their horizons. You know, somebody that would enjoy, you know, seeing me butcher these riffs, you know, playing metal on Telecasters, which is, I guess, is possible. But, you know, please subscribe to my channel. When you guys subscribe and you like these videos, you really boost the algorithm and it gets these videos into, onto phones and onto computer screens and onto televisions, you know, in our area, across the states, and across the world. And that really, really helps my channel, helps the brand, helps what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to make art every day. Musical expression is something that anybody can do. And I've been a teacher since I was 20, so, you know, almost 30 years. I just want to convey that anybody can play, you know, any gender, any color, binary, non-binary, whoever you are, pick up an instrument, a guitar, piano, drumsticks, saxophone, flute, harmonica, something, you know, tap on the steering wheel. There you're making music too. Sing your heart out. Doesn't matter, you know, whether anybody can hear you. It doesn't matter. Hopefully you can, you know, if you can carry a tune, if you can register pitch, or if you can recognize pitch, you know, do it to the best you can. If you can't, sing your ass off no matter what. You know, it's about expressing what's going on inside. And a lot of us really need to do that. Everybody needs to do that. Everybody suffered, you know, this past few years, you know.